Welcome back, CSE 3200 Yukon Stores. We're in video 7 of chapter 16. In the last video, we made an intent to get a contact. It appeared to work. We were able to get into our contacts app, select a contact, but then it became a dead end. We never got anything back from the contacts. That is something we're going to do in this video. And it is something you have to figure out how to do because we don't have direct access to the information in that contacts. That contains sensitive information, first name, last name, phone number, could be plenty of other things that we don't want to release. We might want to release permissions in order to get to the data, but we have to, on this end, know how to do that. Here's how we're going to do it. Android provides an in-depth API for working with the contacts information through something called the content provider. Instances of this class wrap databases and make the data available to other applications. We can access the content provider through Content Resolver. Because we used activity results contracts.pickContact, we might get a URI back as a result. Might, because the user could back out, in which case we would not get the URI. This is not the contact's name or any other information, as I mentioned, but rather just a resource that we can query for that information. And this is more specifically how we're going to do it. We're going to go into crime detail fragment, and we are going to write a function that retrieves the contact's name from the contact information. I need to explain this code, but when I do, I think what I'm going to do is not type it out for you because I'll be explaining it here. I'll just paste it in and make sure that things are going to run. All right, so our function's private fun parse contact selection. We are going to have something called contract URI. It's going to accept in the URI that we had as an output for our intent. It was the second half of the contract for our intent. Then we're going to have this val query fields. It's going to be equal to an array of, well, this is a tongue twister, but what it is boiled down to is much easier than this, contact contract dot contacts dot display name. It's just all of our names in our contacts. Then we're going to have val query cursor, and it's going to equal require activity dot contact resolver dot query, passing in our URI and using our query fields. We'll then have three null values, which we're not making use of. Now let me explain this. Okay, we're going to get a cursor object that to work with. The cursor is going to point to the database table containing a single row and a single column. The row represents the contact that the user selected, and the column represents the contact's name in this case. Query cursor underscore use, have a lambda function set cursor equal to if cursor dot move to first print print. Okay, I'm going to stop there. Cursor dot move to first accomplishes two things. It moves the cursor to the first row and returns a boolean that determines if there is data to read. No data, return false, get out of there. Val suspect is equal to cursor.getString passing in 0. This is an index. The 0 index is going to represent the name from our contact. Finally, these two lines of code I'm not going to explain. We've seen it a few times in our code. It's just going to update the crime. All right, let's get in there. So we want to be in crime detail fragment all the way to the bottom. Here is our get crime report. We're going to put it in after that. Okay, now that isn't all that we have to do. We have like one more line of code that we need to make this work. Remember that last time we left a to do, not this one, this should be gone. We are going to come up here. Here is the result that we have to handle. And we are going to put URI nullable dot let, and then inside of curly braces, parse contact selection. Oh, it's lowercase. Passing in it. All right, looks like I have near it. Nope, it's gone. I'll erase the to-do. And let's run it. And let's go into our app. Let's create a new crime. We're going to say that this crime is eating. Let's go with the classic spelling of donuts. The classic spelling of donuts does not have two O's. Half eaten donuts on counter. And let's just back out of this, make sure we have our new crime. Looks good. Let's go back in. Let's choose a suspect. And we haven't accused David Wallace of anything. Okay, and it says that we have David Wallace. All right. And there you have it. We have now retrieved that information from the database. Now, it feels like that wraps everything up, but not quite. We do have a little bit of polish, a potential bug that we're going to take care of in the next video, and I'll see you there.